There are more than 1.5 billion people out there using the internet every day, and just like you, they're looking for answers. We here at SciShow are looking for answers too. Answers to questions about science and nature and the human body, Earth, and the universe. So we're working with Google and YouTube to answer 10 of the most popular questions searched for on the internet. This is the world's most asked questions. Today's question is, how can I get rid of hiccups? People have all kinds of hiccup remedies that they swear by, none of which seem to have much to do with each other, like swallowing a teaspoon of sugar, or guzzling a glass of water, or just holding your breath. But to figure out how to get rid of hiccups, and why we get them in the first place, you gotta start with getting to know your diaphragm. The diaphragm is a sheet of muscle under your lungs that is one of the most important muscles you have if you enjoy things like breathing. And a hiccup is just an involuntary spasm of the diaphragm that causes it to contract suddenly. When that happens, you take in a gulp of air really quickly until your vocal folds, the membranes at the top of your throat, clamp shut. That's what causes the hic sound. Most of the time, the spasm stops as quickly as it started, and you can just say, "Excuse me," and get on with your life. But sometimes those spasms won't stop, which means it's time to get your diaphragm to relax. To do this, you basically gotta hit the reset button on your nervous system, or at least the part that controls your diaphragm. You can do that in a couple of different ways. One is to stimulate your vagus nerve. That's a nerve that runs down your neck from the base of your brain, and it regulates some of your body's most important functions, including your heartbeat and your breathing. Basically, you need to stimulate this nerve, distract it, if you will, so it'll stop constantly zapping your diaphragm. So some people have luck getting rid of hiccups by swallowing a teaspoon of sugar. Sounds delicious, but it's actually harder than it sounds. The act of gulping down those dry granules can provide just enough confusing stimulus for your vagus nerve to start focusing on your throat and leave your diaphragm alone. Another more common approach to kicking the hiccups is to increase the level of carbon dioxide in your bloodstream. That might seem a little weird, but your natural breathing rhythms are regulated by your CO2 levels, and if they get too high, your nervous system will signal your diaphragm and lungs to make sure they're doing their job. And this is what's behind most of the hiccup-busting techniques you've probably heard of, like holding your breath, or breathing into a paper bag, or drinking a tall glass of water. All that stuff stops your intake of oxygen and ramps up your internal CO2 concentration, which signals your diaphragm to get its head in the game and fix things. If the human body weren't so weird, it wouldn't be so fascinating. And speaking of hiccup cures, of those of you who filled out our SciShow survey, 54% said that holding your breath was your preferred method of relieving hiccups, while at a close second was drinking water, with 37%. We're loving answering these questions, but of all the questions in the world, what questions do you most want answered? Let us know on Facebook or Twitter, or in the comments down below, and we will answer the best questions in a new video at the end of the month. Don't forget to use the hashtag WMAQ for World's Most Asked Questions, and stay tuned for more answers here on SciShow. We'll be right back.